Sad and dismal is the story that I will tell to you about the schooner Persian, her officers and crew. They sank beneath the waters deep in life to rise no more, where wind and desolation sweep Lake Huron's rock-bound shore. They left Chicago on their lee, their songs they did resound. Their hearts were full of joy and glee, for they were homeward bound. They little thought the sword of death would meet them on their way, and they, so full of joy and life, would in Lake Huron lay. In mystery their fates are sealed, they did collide, some say, but that is all 'twill be revealed until the judgment day, when the angels come to take their stand and wade the waters blue, and then give forth this loud command, the schooner Persian's crew. Her captain he is no more, he lost his precious life, sank down among Lake Huron's waves, free from all mortal strife. A barren coast now hides from view his manly, lifeless form, and still in death is the heart so true that weathered many a storm. And there was Daniel Sullivan, her mate, with a heart as true and as brave as ever was compelled by fate to fill a sailor's grave. Alas, he lost his noble life, poor Daniel is no more, for he met a sad, untimely end upon Lake Huron shore. Oh, Daniel, Dan, your many friends mourn the fate that has on you frowned. They look in vain for your return back to Oswego town. They miss the sly glance of your eye, your hand they'll clasp no more, for still in death you now do lie upon Lake Huron shore. Her sailors' names I did not know, except in one or two, but down in the deep they all did go, they were a luckless crew. Not one escaped to land to clear the mystery o'er, but to lie adrift by heaven's command in lifeless form ashore. And now around Presque Isle the seabirds scream their mournful notes along, enchanting the sad requiem, the mournful funeral song. They skim along the waters blue, and then aloft they soar o'er the bodies of the Persian's crew that lie along the shore. Thank you.